three-dimensional printing, how we make things will never be the same.
It's really a tool that allows you to build anything that you want.
Manufacturing worldwide is getting a makeover.
People are already working on printing human organs.
3D printing is changing everything from healthcare to education.
When the 3D printer arrived, I was truly like a child on Christmas Day.
It's in the home, it's in kitchens, it's even in space. 3D printing, how it will change your life in this week's edition of Earth 2050.
Hi, I'm Joe Pettit and welcome to Earth 2050. Every once in a while, there's a revolutionary development that tends to sneak up on us. And then all of a sudden we find it's a regular part of our lives. 30 years ago, it was the personal computer. Now, it could be 3D printing. And it's already having a profound impact.
Even though this technology has been around for a long time, it's really only starting to take hold today.
Manufacturing doesn't just happen in a factory, it now happens in your home or in your school.
So what exactly is 3D printing? It's literally creating something from nothing, which is not the way products have traditionally been made. That old way is called subtractive manufacturing.
Subtractive manufacturing has been around for thousands and thousands of years, ever since the first person took a stick and a knife and carved it into a spear. That was subtractive manufacturing.
3D printing reverses this process. You start with an idea, you create it digitally in a computer, and print. Actually use a printer to build a solid three-dimensional object from that design. It's the opposite of subtractive manufacturing.
What is 3D printing?
So 3D printing, it falls under this field of additive manufacturing. Additive manufacturing being this concept of building something up layer by layer, adding the layers together, essentially.
With a 3D printer, we're laying down material one layer at a time until we build that three-dimensional object.
So why is this concept so revolutionary? Because there are virtually no limits. If you can create an object on your computer, the 3D printer can build it.
It's very easy to do. That is, we say complexity is free. The printer doesn't know the difference between whether it's a simple part or, you know, a complex part. It just comes out.
Complexity doesn't cost you anything. The machine really doesn't know whether I'm building just a block with a hole in it or an extremely complex heart or even DNA sequence. The machine doesn't care.
And since you're starting with an idea on a computer and building it up from scratch, 3D printing is not only faster, it's cheaper.
It's really what we call digital manufacturing. It's the idea that you can go from digital to physical.
3D printers can do everything from building small objects like toys to heavy manufacturing.
So we're starting to see people learn how to print parts of spaceships, of airplanes.
Designers of this aerodynamic, energy-saving car called the Irby made most of it with a 3D printer. All sorts of materials, from metal to plastic to sugar, can be used to create products. 3D printing is revolutionizing healthcare.
People are already working on printing human organs. In fact, there's some very successful work that's already been done.
This is a very important tool. It's made it possible for us to do a lot of things.
3D printers have actually saved lives. Surgeons having to operate on newborns with congenital heart defects, which is an incredibly difficult operation, have turned to 3D printers.
What this is a scale model of an infant's heart that was built as a pre-surgery planning model. They were trying to figure out what's the best way to do this surgery without impacting the child in a harmful way.
The child's x-rays and MRI scans were enough to create a computer model of his heart, which was then built with a 3D printer.
They called me up and said, listen, I've got a model of this heart. You want to see it?
Thanks to the 3D model, surgeons knew exactly what they were dealing with before they went into the operating room.
It should benefit the patient because it benefits the surgeon. If you plan in advance, you can minimize the time it takes to work inside the heart and do the repair.
What may be most revolutionary about 3D printing is not how it makes things, but that everything that it makes, like the child's heart, can be custom made for every person. And that could change our relationship to many of the products each of us use every day.
We see 3D printing as an incredibly powerful technology, a very disruptive technology, a technology that really has the potential to influence and shape almost every part of the world as we know it today.
coming up. We explore where 3D printing is now and where it's going on the road to 2050.
It's amazing. It completely unleashes creativity. You can create just anything that comes to mind.